San Diego, what's got you down? Do you need a winning team for a winning town? Then there's one thing I know for sure. A soccer's game is a miracle cure. Come on, sports fans, don't be glum. We've got the team that's number one. If you're down and feeling blue, ask Dr. Coker what to do.
Take this tonight and call me in the morning, cause you'll want more, they have it for me.
We're the Soccer's Golden Blue. World championships are nothing new. We've won one, two, three, and four. But we're not done, we want some more. More rings to show that we're the best. Root for one more, it's all that's left. So come and join us in the fun. We're gonna get one for the thumb.
Double Deuce and Triple E, he's the one and only Julie V. He'll use his head, he'll use his feet, there's no defender that he can't beat.
In fact, I beat them like a drum, I'm gonna get one for the thumb.
Folks come and go, but never fear, Captain Wilrich is still here. The other players look to Gene to orchestrate this symphony.
The scoring always goes too sweet, but I can touch them with my feet.
Number 20 does it all. His shots take off like cannonballs. Over hill and over dale is how he'll hit the title trail.
I won't let my teammates down. They'll ride the Bronco to the crown.
We're the Soccer's, you're the fans. We use our feet, you use your hands. Together we can have some fun. We're gonna get one for the thumb.
Sometimes the ref makes things real hard when he whips out his little car. But we really come alive when we're out there 4-on-5.
So take a shot, we dare you to. No goal patrol won't let it through.
And if they do, it's still no use. Our goalies take so much abuse. But it's their job, and they take pride that all the goals go in on the other side.
I take care of all these lads, when they're good and when they're bad. One for the thumb would be so nice. Hey lads, why don't we do it twice?
Yeah!
Alright coach, we love this game, we love this town. We've got the greatest fans around.
But there's a battle to be won,
so the future is bright for everyone.
Reach out your hand, you can't refuse.
With a team like this, how can we lose? Cause we're the Soccer's Golden Blue. World championships are nothing new. We've won one, two, three, and four.
Every year, a stretch drive that electrifies the city, confounds the experts, and adds to the legend. It's quite a story. This is a dynasty built on a tradition of soccer excellence. San Diego has always been a consistent outdoor winner and approached the indoor game with reluctance. Indeed, soccer's owner Bob Bell refused to participate in the North American Soccer League's initial indoor campaign, proving nobody's perfect. When his club began to compete 1 year later, they finished dead last in the Southern Division. But there was more here than met the eye. The new kids on the block were learning the game. How to play the crazy bounces, the premium on quickness, the subtle differences between the indoor and outdoor game. And a vision of the future began to emerge.
The excitement, the speed, the sound, the style of play, the compactness of the field, all of the characteristics of an ideal sport for the American sports fan of the 1980s is contained in the indoor soccer game as it's played in the MISL.
His name was Julie V, and it became quickly apparent that his talents were ideally suited to the new game. He was a veritable scoring machine, chalking up 40 goals during the 18-game season. With a Julie V, success could not be far away. 1 year later, the Soccers would lose 7 of their first 9, and then explode. In January of 1982, San Diego began a run that brought 8 wins in 9 games and a Western Division title. By March, a now familiar message lit the marquee for the very first time. the sport and the Sockers were for real. And when the playoffs rolled around, San Diego was merely awesome. Six straight victories culminated in a sweep of Tampa Bay. The city of San Diego had its first professional sports championship in 18 years. It felt pretty darn good. It would also prove habit-forming. Produced, it became increasingly apparent that this was somehow more than a soccer match. There was genuine emotion here. Players and fans united in an almost tangible expression of pride and purpose. It would not come easily. This game would be a war.
The Sockers held together with gauze, tape, and confidence. They've won 18 straight here at the Sports Arena. And this place is pumped up. They sold every ticket in 5 hours.
Donnelly into the corner for Coker. Addy. Back out along the wing for Woolrich. Back to the slot for Donnelly. Now to Dana. Cassie has a look. Plays it off. The defenders. Be the Holly. And wide. Coker shot. He scores! The Sockers were on top of the world. What could they possibly do for an encore? And there it was. Three consecutive championships for San Diego. And no one was about to stop counting now. Because in September of 1984, the Sockers made the deal of the century, acquiring indoor soccer's greatest player. Steve Jungle, the most prolific scorer in the history of the sport, was now a member of the sport's greatest team. And the beat goes on. Legends and heroes that created a storied past and a sparkling future. The San Diego Sockers, champions of the great indoors.
Well, I don't know what Julie B's reading. I know it's the game notes. He doesn't have to read that to see if he was supposed to be up for a penalty. Something has just landed in the field. Is that somebody's sport jacket?
I think that's
what is that? A blanket?
Some a drape that fell off the new scoreboard. Yeah, it looked like Superman dropped his cape for a minute there or something. But it's one of those.
That's one way to stop San Diego, isn't it?
And they're coming to take me away, haha. They're coming to take me away, ho ho, hee hee, haha, to the funny farm.
And you'll have a whistle and a foul against Chico Borja. And he's all over Essie Bahamas. And he's going to get a card here. Yeah, he gets a red card. Whoa, he's gone.
Oh, they're coming to take me away.
You thought it was a joke, and so you laughed. You laughed and laughed, and then you left, but now you know I'm utterly mad.
And now y'all
It's the fastest growing, most exciting sport in North America. To the fans, indoor soccer was more than just a game between two teams. This was exciting, entertaining. Fans all over the country fell in love with a sport that has it all.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Civic Center. Sold out for the home opener of the Baltimore Blast. I'm Al Schrawlig along with Ted Patterson. In just a few seconds, you'll be meeting the Baltimore Blast for the very first time in their home opener. The atmosphere here is absolutely electric as it's the Baltimore Blast and the Philadelphia Fever, both with a 1-3 record and both of them struggling to find some kind of secret to what makes this thing all happen in indoor soccer. Right now, let's pick up the introductions of both teams on the field.
Sure, indoor soccer arrived in the state of Missouri. The first-year fans of St. Louis were awarded with the MISL's first annual All-Star game.
Timeout per team per half.
Witness the checkerboard.
That's about it. Other than that, this game just goes. Non-stop action. Julie V now plays it off left wing. This is trouble for the Central Division. It's Grigorov and Sagoda. Grigorov. Oh, nice ball control by Fred Grigorov inside. Julie V. V saw he had an opening, a little opening at the near post. Took the pass and then directed it right into the edge of the goal mound, but here comes the Central Division. Petcher has the defender down, Lawson trip, Petcher inside, oh, it's wide, Petcher, he scores! Listen to the crowd, they love it!
So impressed with the All-Star game, the Major Indoor Soccer League awarded the championship series to the fans of St. Louis. It would be a doubleheader on Friday night with a championship game on Sunday. Game two Friday night of the semifinals, cross-state rivals, Wichita Wings against the hometown St. Louis Steamers.
Cannot afford to do. Wings on top of the Steamers, 6-1. Christensen's second playoff goal from Helmut Dudek at 13:09, 6-1. We're closing out the third quarter and the Wings look tough as ever. Can the Steamers come back? They bombarded Wichita that whole third quarter, but could not score. Controlling the ball in their own zone and doing a nice job of it. To the right, Slobo Ilievski. Steamers in white with the blue trim. Look at the Steamers here, Terry, in the fourth quarter. They're rolling, but keep in mind one statistic. Three goals in this league have been scored in a minute. This is the pocket rocket, Tony Glavin. Steamers got some steam right now. Shot by Glavin. Rebound shot by Carl Rose. Off the boards, Keogh. St. Louis pressuring. Shot by Keogh. He scores. We got a game on our hands now, sports fans. There's a four-goal differential right now. St. Louis, Tony Glavin. The pocket rocket runs right into George Lane, who's about twice his size. Rebound shot, Plowman out front, shot, he scores! This place is going crazy! Berserk in St. Louis. The music says ain't no stopping us now. And that's exactly what the theme must be on the Steamers bench. It's now Wing 6, St. Louis 3.
Miraculously, after trailing by 5 goals, St. Louis had pulled within 1. The Wichita coach pleads with his team, hold on for just 1 more minute.
Remaining in the fourth quarter. Steamers off the free kick. Wings on top, 7-6. Vic puts it down low, loose ball, Henry scores! Unbelievable!
Regulation time tied in what was already the most dramatic game one could imagine. The two teams played a 15-minute sudden death overtime. Scoring 14 goals during regulation time, no one could score in the overtime. The game went to a shootout. And it was on this penalty that St. Louis would be awarded a penalty kick. This kick could put the Steamers into the championship game on Sunday.
They're forcing his right foot. Look at him. He is taking that post. Here's the shot. He scores. Listen to this crowd. Look at the Steamers. In one of the greatest victories and comebacks in the history of the Major Indoor Soccer League, the St. Louis Steamers are this current
its faith in the fans of St. Louis, the Major Indoor Soccer League had created the perfect ending to only its third season. The script was written, the scene was set. 12 teams had started the season, and it would be the defending champions, the only champions the league had ever had, the New York Arrows, against the emotional hometown favorites, the St. Louis Steamers.